Hey Java developers and people managing JVMs. In this video, we're going to do a brief hands-on introduction to JDK Mission Control, or JMC for short, which I'll be using for the rest of this video. JMC 9, as of the recording of this video, is the most recent version of JMC, so we'll be using that version for this video. Though, we won't really touch on new features in this video, so if you're still on JMC 8 or even 7, you should still be able to follow along. If you're interested in what changes were introduced in JMC 9, check out my video covering what's new in JMC 9 here. For those new to JMC, JMC is a tool for profiling and debugging applications running on a JVM. JMC accomplishes this by being able to read JDK Flight Recorder, JFR, files and visualize them, as well as being able to connect to the Java Management Extension, JMX, API. I know, JMC, JFR, JMX, that's a lot of new acronyms you might not be familiar with. Luckily, those are the only new ones we'll be covering in this video. For more on JFR, you can check out our series on JFR on dev.java, link in the description. For JMX, check out this Oracle guide. For JMC, well, more on that in this video. During this video, we will cover both reading JFR files, using JMC to control JFR on a JVM, and connecting to JMX. We will also review some of the charts and graphs JMC provides and how they can be used to find performance bottlenecks and debug issues. Though we won't cover all the functionality JMC provides in this video, but we'll look at making more videos covering areas we didn't get to here in the future. If you have used JMC before, but it has been a few years, or you have recently upgraded from JDK 8 to 11 or later, there might be a few important changes to note. 1. JMC and JFR were open source as a part of the JDK 11 release. This means that you no longer need a commercial license to use these features in production. Also means the VM options unlock commercial features and flight recorder are no longer supported because, well, they're no longer needed. 2. Both JMC and JFR have had small name changes. In both cases, the J now stands for JDK instead of for Java. So you're not mishearing me when I say JDK Mission Control or JDK Flight Recorder. And 3. JMC is no longer bundled as a part of the JDK, but is a separate binary. So terminal commands like JMC to open JDK Mission Control, like you might have seen in some older videos or articles, no longer works, or at least not without doing some system map pathing, which we won't be covering in this video. You can download JMC 9 at this link, with builds available for all the major platforms. Finally, an important change for this tutorial that came with JMC 9 is that you need JDK 17 or later to run it. However, while JMC requires JDK 17 to run, it can still read JFR recordings from JDK 7 U40 or later. You can download JDK 17 here or JDK 22 here, which is the most recent release of the JDK at the time of this recording. Alright, let's get started. For this video, we will be using a simple application that contains a few bugs and performance issues. As a disclaimer, don't use this code as an example of how to write code for your production applications. You can find the code for this application at this GitHub repo, link in the description. We will start the application mostly as normal, but we will include the start flight recording VM option with a file name of jmcexample.jfr and dump on exit set to true. We will run this application for a couple of minutes, I sped up time here, and then kill the application. Okay, let's analyze this application in JMC. If we open JMC, we can drag and drop the JFR recording into JMC to open it. By default, on the left side of the screen, there should be a panel with an outline tab. The automated analysis should be the first view that pops up. Automated analysis is a rule-based tool that can provide guidance on potential issues and performance bottlenecks in an application. Going down the outline, we can see it's divided into three major categories, representing three different layers. At the top is the Java application. Below that is the JVM, and then finally the environment. Below those categories is the event browser. JFR is an event-based profiling framework. The event browser allows us for filtering and viewing these events. All the data in this whole breakdown is a result of interpreting the events written by JFR to the JMC example file we opened. If we go back up to the Java section, we can look at how we might use JMC to improve the performance of our application. Looking under method profiling, this can give us a view of an indication where most of the CPU resources are being used by the application. At the top is a simple method that brute forces finding prime numbers over a range. Below that is bigInteger.add. If you click on that line, JMC will provide a stack trace, and we can see that this is being called from the method jmctestapplication.work. Using this view, this can help a developer figure out where to spend their time optimizing an application if they are facing performance issues. Improving calls to bigInteger.toString, for example, won't provide much benefit as it only uses a small fraction of CPU time, whereas improving how we find prime numbers could see a dramatic improvement in application performance. So what if you're already running an application that you want to profile? In the JVM browser tab, we can see a list of currently running Java applications. Right-clicking on JMC test application, we can configure JMC to start a JFR recording on the application. We will set it to 20 seconds. One of the great features of JFR is that it isn't required to be enabled on an application at initialization to be used. This can allow developers to capture diagnostic data on a Java application that is experiencing issues in production as they are occurring. Though note that JFR can actually be run indefinitely on applications in production as it has a low overhead of about 1%. All right, it has been about 20 seconds and JMC has automatically opened the recording we just launched. It contains much of the same data as our previous recording, but just for the last 20 seconds of the application was running. In this example, only a single dump will be performed. We can also configure JMC to continuously record a JVM. Once that's configured, under the flight recorder dropdown, we can tell JMC to dump the recording data. Using this method, we can get a near real-time look into a JVM. If we want a real-time view into a JVM, though, we need to use JMX, which JMC also supports. Right-clicking again in the application in the JVM browser, we can select the JMX console. This, by default, will pop up the gauges of use Java heap, CPU usage, and live set and fragmentation. This can be configured by clicking on the plus sign. Here, we can add gauges. If we click on the tabs at the bottom of the page, this provides us different views into the application. On the threads page, we can see that threads 2, 3, and 4 are blocked. This is a result of poor design on the demo application where I have used nested synchronization blocks. Do not use nested synchronization blocks. Rarely would a thread locking issue be so obvious, but JMC was still able to help highlight this issue by showing us some of our threads are being blocked. A good demonstration of how JMC can be used to find bugs in your application. In future videos, we'll explore other ways of using JMC to monitor JVMs to find performance bottlenecks or bugs in an application. If you would like to learn more about JMC or JFR, be sure to check out dev.java, link in the description, or a playlist of JFR and JMC videos on our channel that will come up at the end of this video. Until next time, happy coding!